Well, we defined the definite integral as a means to calculate surface areas, but you have to be careful here. So the definite integrals, they can also be negative. We don't have to restrict ourselves to functions that are only positive or non-negative. Yeah, because we can also form rectangles or surface area that is negative. So here, the rectangles point downwards from the y-axis of the x-axis. So all these surfaces that we have here, so all these rectangles, they contribute in a negative way to the estimates. Yeah, so if we take some sample point over here, then the fxi star is lower than zero. So xi star, fxi star times delta x is now contributing in a negative fashion. Yeah, so definite integrals can be interpreted as surface areas, but only for non-negative functions. Yeah, if a function is non-negative, then we know that all the rectangles point upwards and not downwards. Okay, but the other way around also holds. So if we have a non-negative function on AB, then the definite integral over AB fx dx is actually the area enclosed by the graph of the function y equals 0, x equals a and b.